This one open code feature gives you unlimited AI extensibility with less security compromises, and it's simpler than you may think. After building production systems for 14 years, I was stuck choosing between limited built-in AI tools or using risky MCP protocols that exposes your whole entire system to external dependencies. In the next few minutes, you'll learn how to build secure custom AI functions that give you complete control over your whole development workflow. But here's what the industry doesn't want you to know. This approach eliminates the security risks that MCP protocols introduce while giving you unlimited customization. So let me show you exactly how it's done. All right, we're going to just go to the OpenCode documentation and we're going to go look at custom tools, and that is over here. In custom tools, it pretty much works as a tool call under the hood, and you can set this up both in your local or in your global. It is quite simple to get started. All we have to do is we have to import tool from OpenCode-AI plugin, and we can use tool description in the query with the schema command here, and we can execute the function right here. This is quite powerful. We can build custom tools for our AI development workflows that we can connect to certain agents, and it can actually simplify a few things for us. So sometimes if we want to extract different context from a certain file, we don't need the AI agent to do it. We just need to call the tool, and the tool will do that for us. And we can get a lot more specific with certain workflows using these tool commands. What I'd like about it is you're not installing this bloated MCP and maybe only use one tool or that whole MCP. Execute the one tool here. One thing to note, as always, the file name becomes the tool name. So in this case, if it is saved as database, this tool name is the database. And that's pretty much how we run it. Got an empty folder here. You can see there's nothing here. I'm literally just going to go right here, new folder, and I'm going to create a .opencode here. In the .opencode, I'm literally going to just make a tool, again, singular. And then in tool, I'm just going to say, I'm just going to make a quick one, joke.tx. All right, and I'm just going to copy this. All right, so we've got this error at the moment because we haven't installed anything. I'll show you how to do that now. But I just want to formulate this at the moment. So it's import tool, and I'm just going to say, right, just to show a quick example of how to get a tool working. So we're literally going to be just passing a query param with a string, and then we're just going to return joke and the query param. But you can see we still need to install OpenCode here. So I'm literally just going to open the terminal. All right, to get this working, I'm just going to go CD into the OpenCode folder, and I'm going to tools, And I'm literally just going to run bun init. And this will set up everything for us. I'm just going to say tool, that's fine. Then I'm just going to go bun install. You can also go bun add, and you can literally just grab this whole thing here and just copy it. And that will install our bun package. And this error should, there we go. So we can see our joke is here. But another thing to note is we've got the tool, but we've got no agents that are exposed to it. So we're going to have to do that. So I'm just going to go in here and I'm just going to make .age, and I'm just going to say Joker. I'm just going to make the Joker agent. Right, so this is our Joker agent, very simple. We've told it, it is an instruction here, it's telling it you must grab a joke from the Joker tool. And we made sure the joke tool is there. And again, we've named our file joke, so that's how it's going to work. So it's joke, and then define our tool here. Great. So to get this going, I'm just going to open OpenCode here, and in OpenCode, I'm just going to switch to the Joker agent to show this. Pressing tab, and there we go. We're at the Joker agent, and I'm just going to say, tell me a joke about a dog, for example. We should see it pass the dog through, and we can see it hit the this back, and it just said joke dog. One thing to note. I don't know if you saw that, there was this text saying hello bun. If you have any scripts in this file that just run automatically, it'll be executed every time OpenCode runs. So just as a heads up, I'm just going to delete that so we don't get that again. And we can see it actually returned dog, and then it made its own joke. It's not really what we want, so we can just update the functionality here. All right, I'm just going to exit. That again, so we're going to run OpenCode. gonna make sure we're on the Joker agent over here. I'm just gonna ask it to make a joke about a cat. We can see it returned cat for us. All right, so this is a quick example of how you can make a general tool. We're gonna do a quick example with a bigger, better tool that I think most people would like to use. So we'll jump into that now. All right, so we did a quick example, but this is actually where it gets more mind-blowing. You can actually integrate your AI with different APIs and put it into your coding conversations, and you can do a lot more interesting things. Let's jump into an example to show you how that may work. Show you how powerful custom tools can be. I'm in the OpenCode agents repo that I made, and in here, I've actually built my own tool using Gemini. In Gemini, I've actually calling the Gemini Nano Banana API so I can create images. And this will allow me to create images in my development workflow. To make use of Gemini, I've actually got this image specialist agent here that I created. And you can see here I've listed the different tools I want to use in it, the Gemini multiple analysis, edit, and my generation tool. And I've given it some instructions on how it should create the image and, you know, how it should generate the prompts and everything to give me a style that might be most appropriate for the task that's coming in. And then to use this image agent, I'm actually gonna go through the codebase agent here. And I've told it it has access to it. And in the workflow standards, I say when it's executing a task, if it needs an image, just call it. And that's what we're gonna run through now. So at the moment I have nothing, but I actually wanna just run OpenCode now. And in OpenCode, I'm gonna make sure I'm on that codebase agent that we just edited, and we're on the codebase agent. Now, right on screen here, I'm gonna just show this capabilities of making a general landing page. So it's just gonna be a landing page about an IT consulting company, planning to use some images, and we're just giving it a modern style with some good color scheme. So what should happen is this should run, make some tasks, and then implement our site for us. Let's have a look. All right, so our landing page is built, and we can see it actually generated different images here. And then it actually imported it into the code. So we can see the images are made over here. It's an assets images generation. So if we open this up, we can have a quick look at what these images look like. So that's cloud services, cybersecurity, digital transformation, hero tech, PNG, and then the team. So decent looking images. Just to see how this looks, I'm just gonna open the HTML. All right, so this is the quick landing page it made. So it's got the hero image right there. It made use of some icons, added a team about there and a contact page. As you can see, the results are actually quite fast and simple. We actually used grok code for this one, so it was actually even faster than if I used Sonnet. This just shows you like the power of tooling now. You can build sites like this very quickly. You don't need to have an MCP. You can just hook up the APIs that you really care about, make tools for them, and interact with them. This actually can extend further, like into your own system. So if you want to actually use an API call for your databases, you want to build that into an AI tool, you can. And hopefully you can keep that secure yourself. You don't need to worry about some MCP connecting to your database and maybe the code changes later down the line and they have some new data, who knows. So this way you just secure what you're actually using for your AI tooling. Everyone thinks modern context protocols are the standard way to extend AI tooling, but they're trading security for convenience. With MCPs, you get external processes, network dependencies, and limited customization. But if you use custom tools, as we've shown now, you get direct execution, zero dependencies, and unlimited customization. You own the whole stack. No external attack surfaces to worry about. So here's a challenge to you. Create your own custom tool now for your own workflow. And the way you can think about doing this, every time you find yourself doing something repetitive, think about, could you actually make a custom tool to do this? One example could be if you run a test suite and you want certain tests always run, you can just make a tool and tell the AI to call that tool to get the test suites running. So if this changed the way you think about AI tools, hit that subscribe button. I'll be covering more advanced custom tooling patterns like this with real-world integration. This will be a constant theme of this channel. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.